Hey, good morning. I'm enjoying some coffee. Yesterday's a fantastic day. Got a little bit of footage of everything that went on. I was able to get back on my tools, and man, it sure felt good to be alive. And I really enjoy doing that, but so rarely do I get to anymore these days. And, so we'll just have to see. But take a look. It was productive, and this property is going to be coming along, and hopefully we will have it up and going real close to January 1st is what the goal is. This is a house that I bought about 2.5 years ago. It's been sitting. We did put windows in it. I've just got a new roof on it a couple months ago. We dug this palm tree up, got to cut it in half so we can load it up in the truck. We're going to be running a new water line from the meter all the way to the house right there. And we just installed a load-bearing beam. I own that house as well, and these were definitely built by the same person. It's virtually the same floor plan, just flip-flopped. We gutted it all the way down, had spray foam put in the ceiling, and there used to be a wall that went right across there. You can see on that seam, and I wanted this open floor plan, so we took that wall out and we've gone in there and cut those trusses, put 4 2x12s that are 20 foot long together, and then we're going to be tying these trusses in. And so we'll make all that happen and we'll get it together. Somebody's been coming in and out of here. Why, I don't know, but they have. At least they were nice enough to leave the screen and did not damage it. Got a little electrical going on, a lot of electrical. This house should rent for about $1,300 a month when I'm done. We're gonna run all new plumbing lines. Now we got the first one that we've tied in, nailed with a hanger on that beam. Got it right there, married up. So right behind me, those French doors right there, I put those in about 15 years ago. That used to be a double window. We cut it. And I was planning on building a big deck going all the way across the back of the house right here. And met a gal, moved in with her. House was a rental for 10, 12 years. And so, you know, life happens and this and that and everything. But I am back here because this is the only home that I have, or I should say, it's the only house that I've owned that I put pictures on the wall, and that makes it a home. So that happened in 2015, my father died from cancer, and I really looked at my life and asked myself, what is it that you can do that brings happiness and joy that you have control over? And getting back to this house is what I wanted. I love this neighborhood, just everything about it. That right there, where you see that different color brick, that was actually the original back door. We took that out of there because I did the second bathroom that y'all have seen pictures of. And that was what Leo and his crew bricked it up and everything, and turned out real nice for me. So, you know, the significance of that house that you just saw with the load-bearing beam that we put up in the attic is that I was working with a coach. And at the time, I had 3 houses that I had bought that were just sitting. And we weren't making any progress on them. And of course, the rentals weren't making enough money to support the crew and me, and then be able to put money into them as well. So we ended up having to start doing some things differently, so to speak. You know, and we were taking jobs from the outside, so to speak, doing them, and then we would do some work on my stuff. Well, unfortunately, I never said, or I did not say no enough, and so that house just slipped by the wayside. But the thing that I found out working with the coach was I really like to find the deals. I like to negotiate the deals. I like to purchase them, and then I move on.
And the thing about it is that the way the coach explained it to me, and it's totally true, I saw it, is that after the purchase is made, the high is gone for me, the thrill, the chase, the whatever, it's gone. And so then I would move on to another one. Well, I became fixer-upper rich and cash poor. And the thing about it is that having houses sitting does not get me any closer to my long-term goal, okay? And that's why I talk about, one, working with a coach is absolutely phenomenal because they can point out things that you might not see yourself. The other thing is that with them not being your friend, they're a lot more likely to say things that are going to be helpful, and they also might be hurtful, but they're going to be a lot more helpful to get you where you want to go. And so personally, I highly recommend it, okay? And here's the thing is that unless you're reading a whole lot of books, watching a whole lot of videos, getting a bunch of outside information coming in here, or you get an epiphany from God, then everything you know has got you right where you're at. And if you want to be somewhere different, you're going to have to get some different information and then put that into action in your life, okay? So I found out, and I looked at it, and so I ended up cutting one of those properties loose. I had to get to the point of, you know, and it's just like I tell people about buying that truck that I just bought. You know, that truck is a tool. I use that to help make money. And all of these houses are just tools. You know, you got to take your emotions out of them in the sense that they're a stepping stone to get you to a certain point. And, you know, of course, 90% of them don't keep the house as nice as I'd like for them to. They don't take care of it as good as I want them to, you know, and those are things that I really can't control. But I am going to be controlling the yard work because we're going to start taking that over and increasing the rent significantly to justify that. The problem that I'm having is that people are letting shrubs and stuff like that grow in the fences, and then they're also letting it grow around the air conditioners, which is bad. And then when you have vines growing up the side of the house, it starts to rot the wood a whole lot quicker. So no more of that. I say all of this to you that if you are on this journey towards financial independence or just wanting to do better, improve your life some way, somehow, you know, or hell, you might be wanting to wake up and say, hey, man, you know, I want to be making $50,000 a week. Okay. I would say 99.9% of the people that I talk with that are in a position that I would trade places with that have done anything significant have had a coach or a mentor some way, somehow, okay? They might not have had one formally that they're actually paying and kind of signed up and got on board with. However, they got somebody that they are closely talking with that they respect tremendously what that person has to say. So don't ever discount going that route, so to speak. You hear it all the time. Oh, I'm just going to get out there and I'm going to do it. I got it, man. That's great. There's nothing wrong with that. However, you know, if it takes you 2 years on your own to get to the point of making $100,000, and then it takes you only 90 days to get to the point of making $20,000 a month, but you spent $5,000 with a coach or a mentor, you do the math. Okay, it makes total sense every day of the week to have gone the route with the coach. So back to that house. My goal is by January 1st to have it up and running. It'll probably rent for about $1,200 to $1,400 after we get it done and everything. You know, it'll cost a chunk of money. However, I will be able to turn around and get all of my money back out of it and then move on to another house to look at. And actually, yeah, there's old Mr. Tyson. And so, and today at 1 o'clock, I actually go and look at another house. Guys wanting to sell it to me. If it's in good a shape as what I think it is, then it is a situation where I can buy that house and do a little bit of repairs. It'll appraise for considerably more than what I'm purchasing it for. And then I can get all my money back out of it. And then, you know, keep on doing this and acquiring more properties. So take a look. I sure appreciate you watching the channel. Hit that subscribe button. Tell all your friends. Got any comments? Let me know. Have a wonderful day.